Hi, today I'm going to explain how to run important accounts payable reports for finance and also how to display the change logs for the supplier master data and also for supplier line items so you can identify the user that did any changes to the system. Welcome back. Today I'm going to display some accounts payable reports. I'm going to start the demo with SAP FIORI. Then I'm also going to display the reports on SAP GUI. So in case someone doesn't have access to FIORI, he can still follow this video and practice the reports. And also FIORI has some new functions. So even if you are experienced in SAP, you are going to find something useful in this video. So this is SAP FIORI, and I already have a tile group that includes all the reports I'm going to display today. This one is analytics for accounts payable. So these transactions, you can find all of them in the application finder. Here, click on the application finder and you can find them under accounts payable analytics. And if in case you are not able to find any of them, you can use the search box to look for any transaction. So I'm going to go back. The reports I'm going to cover today are the aging analysis, supplier list, supplier balances, and supplier line items. Then I'm also going to show how you can display the changes done to the system on any line item or in any supplier account. So this way you can always track who did the changes and why did he change the master data or the line items. So I'm going to start now with the supplier list. So we start by putting a company code here, so 1710. You can mention different company codes. I'm going to keep the vendor field empty. You can always mention one vendor or several vendors. I'm going to keep it like this. Then click on go. So this is a list of all the vendor master data accounts you have on your system on the company code 1710. You can click on any vendor to display other details. So if I click here, FIORI is giving me multiple options. I can either clear outgoing payments, display supplier balances, manage supplier line items. I can also click on more links and this will display other transactions related to the vendor account. If I click on the number, it is going to display the vendor or the supplier master data. So this is the supplier master data. This is the annual spend, the city, the name, supplier account number, all the details you are looking for. So it has the phone number, address, everything. In the same report, you can display the materials that we are buying from this vendor. And you can also display the purchase orders, the invoices, the purchase contracts, the activities. So actually this is very useful and this is one of the new things I have seen in SAP FIORI. So this is for the supplier account master data. Now I'm going to go back to the list. And go back home to display the other reports. The other report I'm going to display is the supplier balances. So click on this one. So this one will display the supplier balances in a certain company code or in different company codes. So I'm going to also mention 1710 and press enter. Then go. So for the company code 1710 in the fiscal year 2018, this is the balance of all the vendors we have. This is the total debit, credit, balance, and then the cumulative balance adds the different balance from different periods. Then we have the purchases, which are the open purchase orders for the vendors, and we have the imputed interest. Now, if you want to display any period, you can click on the number, and you can also select some specific vendors. So for example, I'm going to select SUPL. I can select this one. I can also click on show all items to select multiple vendors. So I can select this one, this, this, and this. Then click on OK. Go. So this is the balance of the selected vendors. Now I'm going to display the balance for the period 10 only. So I'm going to click here. And FIORI has moved to the transaction of managed supplier line items, which is the third report I'm going to display today. So this one displays the line items or the invoices and the payments and the different transactions posted on the vendor account. You can also change the documents from this screen. So for example, let's say we have an invoice that should be due tomorrow. but we want to change the due date to make it next week, as we agreed with our vendor, or for any reason. So you can actually change some fields in any transaction in SAP. So for example, let's say I want to change the due date of this one. So this is an invoice, number 251456. And this is the document type. This is actually how I know it is an invoice. And this one is open. This is why it is red, which means we have not paid this invoice yet. And it is not due yet. This is why it has the green sign. To display this invoice, I can click on the journal entry number. So click here and click on the number. So this is our invoice. The amount is 1000. The supplier number is here. We have our assignment, the item text. We have the payment method, which is the check. And we also have the baseline date, 31st of October 2018. And this is the payment term. There is a very important note here. For any financial transaction, once we post the financial document, no one is allowed to change the sensitive fields. By sensitive, I mean the amount, the posting date, the account numbers, and other important fields. But if we have authorization, we can change some other fields, such as the text, the payment method, the baseline date. So some fields can be changed, and these are the fields that have no impact on our trial balance or on our financial recording. So in my case, I can change the payment method, I can change the item payment block, I can change the payment term and the baseline date, for example. So I'm going to go back to the report and show you how to do this. So back. So this is again the supplier line item list. I can change multiple documents at the same time, or I can change one by one. So for example, let's assume that I agreed with this vendor that I'm not going to pay him his invoices on time, and I'm going to delay them by 1 week, for example. So I can select multiple invoices. I can click on edit line items, and I can change the baseline date for all of them. So for example, I'm going to say the baseline date will be the end of this month, so 31st October 2018. And also I can change the payment term. So I am going to say if I pay within 5 days or 4 days, I will get 2% discount. Within 8 days, I get 1% discount. And the maximum, I'm going to pay within 10 days. You can also change the assignment, the text, and the dunning details. Then click on OK. Now we have changed the baseline date and the payment terms for these invoices, and the changes have been posted. Now I'm going to go to another screen to display the changes. So for example, if you are a financial manager and you are willing to display the changes that were done to the vendor line items during the period, you can also do this. So I'm going to go back home, and I'm going to use the display item change log for the supplier. Click here. So for company code 1710, I'm going to display all the changes that happened between the period of 1st of October and end of October. I can also select a user, I can select a supplier, an entry, and then click on Go. So this is a list of all the changes done to the supplier line items in this period on the company code, which is very useful to audit the changes done to the system. Now let's move to the vendor aging analysis report. So I'm going to go back home and click on vendor aging analysis, this one. The aging analysis displays the invoices that are overdue for certain time intervals, and also the invoices that are going to be due in the future for certain time intervals also. So if you check this column, this one is from negative 30 to 0, which means the items that are overdue within 30 days and the items that are due today. And then you have the items that are overdue between 60 and 30 days late, which means that we were supposed to pay these invoices 1 month ago. And then you have the invoices that were open between 90 and 61, and the invoices that are open and are overdue for 90 days, which means that we were supposed to pay them more than 90 days ago. And then you also have on the other side, these are the invoices that are going to be due within the next month, invoices that will be due within 2 months, invoices that are going to be due between month number 2 and month number 3, and these are the time intervals. In SAP GUI, when we want to change the intervals, we have to create a new report layout. But in SAP FIORI, you can change this very easily. Click on this button, And then here you can change the width of the aging grid and the number of the aging grid. So for example, if I'm willing to display the report per week, not per month, I can make this 7 days. I can also change the number of the aging grid. This one means I'm going to see 4 weeks in the past and 4 weeks in the future. Then click on go. Now, if you check the report, you have from 0 to negative 7, from negative 8 to negative 14. So now it is per week. And you have 4 weeks in the past and 4 weeks in the future. You can also click on this number, on this column, for example, and you can display the aging analysis per company code, per GL account, per currency, per supplier group. And you can branch from there to different other reports. So you can also branch from this report to the vendor balances and then to the vendor line items to display the exact numbers. So I'm going to do a quick example. So I'm going to click here. I'm going to display the top suppliers. Click on this one. I want to see the open. I can click on open in. I can display the supplier balances and the manage supplier line items. So now we see in the aging analysis that we have 1.53 million euros that are open, and I'm willing to know more details about this. So I can click on manage supplier line items. And in this report, I can display the open items for this vendor. So this way you have a complete audit trail. So you can go from the aging analysis to the exact invoices that are causing the numbers in the analysis. This is it for SAP FIORI. Now I'm going to move to SAP GUI to tell you exactly where you can find these reports. So the reports in SAP GUI can be found under accounting, financial accounting, accounts payable, information system, reports for accounts payable. Here you have the vendor balances, vendor items, and the master data. So here you can find all the reports we displayed in SAP FIORI. For the vendor items, for example, the due date analysis is the aging analysis for the vendors. So if I open this one, so this is the vendor aging analysis we have in SAP GUI. As you see, the layout is not really detailed and not interactive as the one we found in FIORI, but this one can be changed. So for example, if you are willing to have time intervals the same as we have in FIORI, if you are willing to have the time intervals in SAP GUI, you have to create a report layout, and this report layout you can customize in any way you want. You can also branch to other transactions same as SAP FIORI. So for example, if I click on this number and then click on this, call up report, you can go to account balances or line items. So if I click on account balances, so these are the account balances that summed up to the number we have in the vendor aging analysis. So this is an example for the reports in SAP GUI. Now the last thing I'm going to show is how to display changes to the vendor master data. So for example, if someone changed the vendor account number or the vendor email address or the vendor phone number, you have access to display who did the changes and when did he do these changes. So you can go to master records, and here you are going to find a report which is FK04 display changes. Click on this one. Now if you select the vendor account number and the company code, SAP is going to display all the changes done to this vendor account and who did them and when. So this is it for the accounts payable reporting video. I have already recorded other videos to explain the accounts payable invoices and payments. So this is a very good starting point to anyone who is willing to learn SAP financials. So please go ahead, watch all the videos, let me know your feedback, let me know your questions, leave your comments, and if you need any help, let me know, I would be happy to support. Thank you for watching my videos. Don't forget to subscribe to the YouTube channel, like the Facebook page, follow me on LinkedIn, and also help me by sharing the videos so other people can find them.